We got our puppy here. And this doesn't always work for me, so I'm gonna try it today, but let's see how it doesn't always work well for me. Let me try it. Sometimes it just doesn't like the way I describe the prompt, but I'm gonna go ahead and just make a nice big lasso in front of our puppy here, like that. And then I'm going to go to generative fill. I'm gonna add something. I'm gonna say puddle of water. Now, there's a reason I'm doing this puddle of water right in front of the puppy. Let's go here. It adds the puddle of water with a reflection. That just blows my mind. Okay, and of course I got three to choose from. I like that one a lot more. I like that one. So these last, I like the other one looks like it's two, like it's a pothole. Not a puddle. These look like puddles. Okay. So here comes a couple of tips. Number one, I don't think I've ever shown this one publicly. What if you need to move it? It's a layer. You can pick it up and move it, right? So if I pick this up and move it, what's the problem? It doesn't match anymore. So if you do that, you can just hit generate again. When you need to move a cloud in the sky, you need to move something you did, and just hit generate again, and it will then make the new one based on the new location and the new reflection and so forth and so on. So that always blows me away that it does this. Now, the other thing I did not mention in your generative expand, let's say we generate this up, is that we can do generative expand, but I've just been leaving it blank. You don't have to leave it blank. You can type something in that you want it to expand with. So for example, I can say pink bubbles in the sky. That's my prompt. So I'm not just telling Photoshop to expand this canvas up. I'm telling it to fill it with a very specific thing that I'm telling it in the prompt. So when you use generative expand, you can use a prompt just like you do on any other regular selection. That's the tip. One big bubble, one gigantic fake looking bubble. And that's another fake one. So more like that. I did say one. I didn't say S. See, that was my fault. I did not give an S on the end of bubble. So it gave me one. Singular. All right, let's hit generate again. But look at what it did. It gave us the tree line. It gave us the sky. It gave us everything in our one bubble. Let's do bubbles with an S. Not what I had in mind. Those are all horrible. And so again, I would give those poor results. Delete, poor results. Delete, because they just don't match the prompt at all. They don't even look like they're part of the same image. Now again, remember that thing I said, let me throw this layer away. Let's go back to this one. Let's go back to the background here. And is it too late? No, it's not. It might be too late. I'll expand. Yeah, it's too late. All right, so let me undo this for a second. All right, let's try this one more time. Click, expand up. All right, and now we already have our, we already have it on generative expand, great. All right, let's type this in again. Pink bubbles. Bubbles in the rainy sky. There we go. Being very specific with my prompt. And hopefully we'll get something that looks, there we go. That's what I was looking for. So when all else fails, try it again. Just like even start from scratch and try it again. That would be more of what I was thinking of in my head. That's close too, but I don't like that little stripe. I can hit generate again and get three more results. I can just keep hitting generate, but remember to delete the ones you're absolutely not going to use. Like that third one, I'm never going to use. Yeah, that's a cool one. This one, not going to use. That one, I don't like the line, so not going to use it. That's cool. That's cool. That's cool. That's cool. So those would be the four I would pick from and pick the one I want and delete the rest. Or let the client see all four and let them decide. All right. So that is generative expand using a prompt. That's using reflections. That's or creating reflections based on water or things that would be reflective. You could have said mirror. You could have said anything that's reflective, and it would have tried to reflect underneath the subject and created the reflection in it. And that's generative expand using a prompt. Hopefully you're ready to go and play more with generative fill than you're probably already playing. And it's just fun. It's just, I always amazed by what I get. And if I don't get what I quite want, then I just keep trying, changing the prompt, changing the selection, or no prompt, and see what happens. Cheers, everyone. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you on the next one. Bye, everybody.